I'm Anna, and I'm the Head of Learning and Engagement at Tullie House Museum in Carlisle. And I'm here to talk to you today about why we won one of the most prestigious museum awards in the UK, which is the Kids in Museums Family Friendly Award. And I'll start with a brief introduction of our museum. Tullie House is an independent regional museum with an international reach. Where's Carlisle? I hear you ask. Carlisle is a border city. It's on the border between England and Scotland, and our museum welcomes 250,000 visitors every year. We look after nearly 400,000 cultural artefacts on behalf of the local government, and they cover fine and decorative art, natural sciences, archaeology, and social history. Highlights include the largest collection of pre-Raphaelite artwork in the north of England, Roman material of international importance that centres on Hadrian's Wall, a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and a huge collection of specimens that represent the flora and fauna of Cumbria, the most biodiverse county in England. The museum is divided into a number of different areas, all with a very different feel. The oldest part of the building is Old Tullie House, a Grade 1 star listed Jacobean house, where we display some of our fine and decorative art collection. The border galleries, created in the 1990s and updated since then, tell the story of Carlisle and Cumbria from the Ice Age to the present day. The award-winning Roman Frontier Gallery, opened in 2011, explores life in Carlisle in this period. The gallery was created in partnership with the British Museum and features innovative interpretation and display techniques, including a much acclaimed section called the Living Wall, which is this bit here. The Living Wall brings Hadrian's Wall into a 21st century context by exploring Hadrian's Wall in the context of modern day frontiers and barriers and making that comparison. We also have two temporary exhibition spaces, one of which is one of the largest dedicated exhibition spaces in the Northwest. And recent highlights of our programme include a major retrospective of the German artist Anselm Kiefer, created in partnership with Tate and National Galleries Scotland as part of the Artist Rooms programme. And Mechanical Circus, pictured here, which is an exhibition of automata from the Museum Boerhaave in the Netherlands. Along with our partners Wordsworth Trust and Lakeland Arts Trust, we form the Cumbria Museum Consortium, one of 21 major partner museums who receive funding from Arts Council England. We also have partnerships with some of the most prestigious museums in the country, like the British Museum in Tate, as well as international partners like the Imperial Decree Museum in Suzhou, China. Although our reach is significant, as an organisation, Tullie House is relatively small, and we've got an annual budget of just under £2 million and only 39 members of staff split into four departments, as you can see on the structure here. And mine is this little green sliver here, Learning and Engagement. The learning team that I manage is small in size, but huge in impact, and we bring the museum's collections to life. With just four full-time members of staff, in the financial year 2015-16, we engaged with over 20,000 people, including 12,000 school pupils, 1,000 vulnerable adults and young people, and almost 8,000 families. In 2015, we were the winners of the Kids in Museums Family Friendly Award, sponsored by the Telegraph newspaper. Kids in Museums is an independent charity dedicated to making museums open and welcoming to all families, in particular those who haven't visited before. With a dedicated board of trustees and an exciting range of events, partnerships and initiatives, Kids in Museums gives families visiting museums and galleries across Britain a dynamic and powerful voice. The Kids in Museums Manifesto and the Family Friendly Museum Award have been incredibly successful ways of encouraging and guiding museums and galleries across the country to make family visits engaging and enjoyable. The award has been running for 13 years and is one of the most prestigious museum awards in the UK as it is voted for by the public. This year there were over 800 nominations. Tullie House has been entering the award for a number of years and has made the long list of 20 since 2011, which is based on the number and quality of nominations received from the general public. We kept applying as we understood the importance of families in the sustainability of the museum and wanted to shape our programme around this key target audience. Our aim was to make it onto the shortlist of six museums, which is decided by a panel of experts in the field. We did this in 2015 and went on to win the award that same year, a huge honour. I'm going to now take on the difficult task of trying to explain exactly why we won it. Not because we didn't deserve to, of course we did, we're fabulous, but because it's hard to pin down into a short presentation. And it's also hard because one of the reasons why we won the award is because the museum has a kind of magic atmosphere that's really hard to put into words until you visit us. I'll give it a go. Tullie Tullie House was established in 1893 and occupies a unique place in Carlisle as a community and tourist asset. Staff and visitors feel a strong sense of ownership of the space. It is comfortable and familiar, and because of this, it is a safe space where all visitors, but particularly families, can be inspired and challenged to think differently. Tullie is an important community resource. Carlisle as an area consists of the city of Carlisle and surrounding villages, most of which are rural. The population of just over 100,000 is characterised by extremes. 25% of the population is considered financially hard-pressed, with an average income of £15,000 and high pockets of unemployment. However, Carlisle also has some very affluent areas, particularly in the rural villages. Tullie House is one of only a handful of cultural venues in the city, and we have a vital role to play in enhancing our local residents' quality of life by giving them access to art, culture, and opportunities to take part on their doorstep. In the past few years, we've undertaken in-depth analysis of our audience demographics. Just over 60% of our visitors come as part of family groups, and a high percentage of them are local. To appeal to this audience and to increase visitor numbers, we've developed a programme that is dynamic, offers something new on every visit, and encourages families to think of Tullie House as their space. We subscribe to the Kids and Museum's Family Friendly Manifesto, and excelling in all of these areas was a key reason behind us winning the award. Following these principles is simple and doesn't have to be expensive. We are proud that we won the award without spending thousands of pounds on brand new interactives or state-of-the-art digital technology. We won because we are passionate about families, and passion isn't expensive. I'll now run through some of the key elements of the Kids and Museums Manifesto and how Tullie House subscribes to them. In order to win the award, we had to receive excellent feedback from five families who went undercover and visited the museum over the summer. The feedback was based on how well we performed against the manifesto, and some of their feedback is included on the slides. So the first one I'm going to start with, appropriately enough, is begin at birth. Tullie is a space where parents feel comfortable bringing their very youngest. We run toddler and baby sessions every fortnight in spaces around the museum, including the galleries and gardens. We offer these sessions free of charge and have created a community of mums, grandparents and dads who have adopted Tullie toddlers as part of their routine. Activities include sensory specials with edible sand and ice to play with, but where possible, we always link activities to our collections, especially our natural science collection, with butterflies, bugs and birds being particular favourites. One of our most recent initiatives for toddlers has been creating a temporary play space for families. Called the Tullie Explorers Gallery, the space was divided into areas based on our collections, art play, history play and nature play, with a final area filled with soft play equipment, including a ball pool, play mats, giant building blocks and a slide. Including soft play equipment was met with some resistance within the museum at first. A number of staff, generally curators, didn't feel it was appropriate to have equipment like this in a museum, that having it in their collections might result in damage and that it wasn't educational enough. I'm happy to say that these fears were soon put to rest, and the feedback we've had from the Tullie Explorers Gallery has been exceptional. Having soft play equipment brought in new audiences. Families who weren't sure that a museum was for them were attracted by the mention of something they were familiar with and gave them the confidence to visit for the first time. Children learn through play. There's lots of evidence and studies out there highlighting this, particularly in America, where the power of play is a concept that has been embraced by many specialist children's museums. This quote from Professor of Psychology, Dr. Alison Gottnick, sums up our approach to activities in the museum for under fives. When children engage in pretend play or explore alternative worlds, they are learning what people are like, how people think, and the kinds of things people can do. This helps children learn to understand themselves and other people, and this kind of understanding leads to social adjustment in school and social competence in life. We wanted children who visit the Tullie Explorers Gallery to create their own imaginary world inspired by our collection, be this taxidermy animals in our nature play area or hidden objects in our archaeological sandpit. We wanted them to be so busy having fun they didn't notice they were learning, and the feedback we've had has proved this worked. The exhibition is now closed, but due to the positive feedback, we're running Tullie Explorer play sessions once a week on the galleries for babies and toddlers using equipment from the exhibition. And we're also planning to create a permanent children's play gallery within the museum. The next one is invite teenagers in. Being family friendly doesn't just mean appealing to parents, carers, and children. We are committed to providing accessible space for all ages and actively seek out opportunities to work with the challenging but rewarding age group of teenagers. Our Young People's Programme is also award-winning. Our Community and Young People Coordinator received the Golden Apple Award for Youth for her outstanding work with young people in Cumbria. One of the key strands of our programme is our youth panel, our young persons group, the youth panel they're called, who contribute to exhibitions and events and take part in innovative projects. Most recently, they've designed and launched an app that takes visitors on a cultural crawl around Carlisle, featuring film and animation. In order to fully commit to this principle of inviting teenagers in, we've embraced inclusivity. As well as engaging with young people who are already interested in the museum and history, like the youth panel, we work with those who may experience barriers to accessing Tullie House through challenging personal situations. One of the organisations we work regularly with is NACRO, a national social justice charity who work with developing the skills and employability of vulnerable young people not in education, training or employment. Each year we run projects with their learners focusing on subjects that appeal to them and that will help develop their creative skills. Making the museum and our collection relevant is our key strength when working with this age group. We have to compete with technology, social media, and the frustrations and feelings that simply come with being a teenager. So we have to work hard to engage with their interests and passions. For example, as I mentioned at the start of this presentation, our major exhibition last year was a retrospective of the work of contemporary artist Anselm Kiefer. To an art fan, the exhibition was an easy sell. Kiefer is one of the most important post-war European artists, and this was the first time ever that this collection of work had been on display outside of London. To a teenager with no interest in modern art, however, this doesn't mean anything. We decided to focus on one of Kiefer's key themes, identity. We worked with the learners from NACRO on thinking about how Kiefer's work might relate to their sense of themselves. This resulted in a project called Kiefer to Music, where young people created a blog featuring YouTube clips of songs from their favourite bands that they felt connected with Kiefer's work. Our projects often use the Arts Award framework, a national scheme encouraging young people to develop their skills in the creative sector and achieve an accredited qualification. Most recently, we've been working with the Carlisle Young Carers Group, who have been spending their valuable respite time paid for by the local council at Tullie House, achieving their Bronze Arts Awards. Our Young People's Programme has outreach as a core strand. We think it's really important to reach out to young people on their turf and on their terms. Building this trust and rapport by going to them not only gives them the confidence to take part in a session at the museum, but also reassures them that it isn't a boring environment only relevant to old people, a misconception we enjoy proving wrong. At the next point on the manifesto is share stories and say please touch. Encouraging our families to participate by sharing stories and having conversations, using objects and displays as a catalyst for this, is something we always encourage. One of the ways we do this is using our Tullie Mouse character. Part of the museum is in an old Jacobean house which has traditionally been underused by families, as it's quite an imposing space where visitors feel they have to be really quiet. We decided to give Tullie Mouse a home in there. Children can look through his mouse hole into his house and write him a letter sharing the story of their visit. This has proved incredibly popular, and since we created this space at the start of the summer holidays, over 300 letters have been sent, with Tullie Mouse writing back to everyone. I've even got Tullie Mouse in my luggage. He's gone on holiday, so I have to take pictures of him around Dubrovnik, enjoying the sights. In our collections conversation programme, visitor experience staff encourage visitors to handle and interact with artefacts. Discussions focus on sharing thoughts rather than the right or wrong interpretation of facts. Each of our galleries has a bespoke set of objects related to the collections on display that visitors can handle. We offer collections conversations free of charge to our visitors to create added value and add a special memory to their visit. Be flexible and aware of different families' needs. Being flexible is about acknowledging that families come in all shapes and sizes. It's essential to get to know who your families are to excel in this area. For example, according to statistics collected for us by the Audience Agency, 23% of the population within a 15-minute drive time of Tullie House come under their categorisation of Facebook families, who are characterised as a cash-strapped younger group, live in suburban and semi-urban areas with high unemployment, state arts and culture play a very small part in their lives, and are digital natives, especially high users of social media. This is a significantly higher percentage in the UK as a whole, with just 12% of the population falling within this category nationally. This means that nearly a quarter of our potential local family audience have limited disposable income and don't go to museums. Knowing this, we make sure our programme has a wide range of activities at different price points and actively engage with families through our Tullie Families Facebook page, examples of which you can see here. Our engagement programme is as inclusive as possible through a mix of charged activity and free events. Every weekend during term time, we run family-friendly Sundays, an afternoon of free drop-in activities themed around objects from our collection. Object handling is particularly important for children as it teaches them empathy, and all our family learning programmes involve getting hands-on with objects in some way. During school holidays, we run drop-in activities 3 times a week. We don't charge for these activities, but since we started asking for donations and invested in this beautiful donations box, we've found that we're getting more than enough to cover the cost of materials and staff. This summer, we also ran a culture camp for children aged 7 to 13 years old. The group explored the museum, visited our partner sites, and took part in a huge range of art, craft, and drama activities and achieved their Discover Arts Award. We chose to heavily subsidise places on Culture Camp to ensure that children from low-income families could take part without the barrier of cost. However, in the current economic climate, we are having to focus more and more on income generation and being sustainable. This means that amongst the many free activities for families, we include events and activities with a ticket price. This summer, our main exhibition for families was based on the best-selling How to Train Your Dragon books by Cressida Cowell, also a major film series by DreamWorks. Because this is such a well-recognised brand, we felt this was an opportunity for us to introduce some higher-priced family events, as we hoped the familiar brand would encourage higher spend. One of these events was our first ever sleepover for families. We've been running sleepovers for our museum club, the Tullie Time Travellers, and groups like Brownies and Scouts for many years, but this was the first time we invited the public to stay the night at the museum. We charged £30 per child and £15 per adult, and were delighted to have 40 participants on the night, taking part in an exciting range of activities. The feedback was exceptional, with 94% of participants giving it top marks for quality of experience, and many saying they would have actually paid more. As well as being flexible with our pricing, we're also flexible with our opening times. One Sunday a month, we open our galleries early to children with autism and their parents, siblings, and carers. We offer craft activities and object handling and ensure that light and sound levels are suitable for the children. This September, we introduced Explorer backpacks. Each backpack includes objects like magnifying glasses, binoculars, and trails. We did this because after running the sessions for a few weeks, we found that some of the children weren't comfortable engaging with an unfamiliar adult, so the Explorer backpacks take the pressure of interacting away by allowing the child to engage with the collection on their own terms. Positive feedback from the sessions has meant that we'll be working towards achieving an Autism Access Award, a standards framework for public buildings that will demonstrate we are autism friendly. Finally, be the core of our community. We are passionate about making children and adults feel comfortable in the museum. We have recently launched our own museum manifesto that puts learning and the community at the heart of everything we do. We want to develop active participants, be inclusive, inspire learning, and be a catalyst for thinking differently. We want Tullie House to be a third space for the community, away from home and work. And we aim to do this through our changing exhibition and events programme, founded on principles of co-creation, by breaking down economic barriers to access through reduced entry for locals and free initiatives, and by making our spaces as inviting as possible. The combination of welcoming, friendly atmosphere, huge range of activities, and an organisation-wide ethos that embraces families is what makes Tullie House stand out and is why we won this award. We commissioned a film highlighting some of the activities with families and visitors that we ran over the summer, and I'm going to show a couple of minutes of it here. I hope it helps a little bit in explaining just what that Tullie House magic is and how we embody the principle of being the core of our community every day. Tullie House Museum and Art Gallery Trust is an independent regional museum with an international reach, welcoming over 250,000 visitors through our doors every year. Though small in size with just 4 full-time members of staff, the Tullie House Learning Team inspired and engaged with over 20,000 people last year through our events, activities and bespoke programming strands for schools, families, vulnerable adults and young people. And last year we were delighted to win the National Kids and Museums Family Friendly Award. This film explores some of the life-changing work we did over the summer of 2016. This week is the first time we've done a week of activities for children as a self-contained group. So we do lots of activities over the summer for families, as drop-ins, but this is the first time we've had children all day, every day for a whole week.
I think they're really good. good at working with families. I've been lucky, I've worked with them on a number of projects, but the most recent one was the family, it was their first family sleepover, where the families slept together overnight in the galleries.
The sleepover was an amazing opportunity to let our families explore the secret behind the scenes world of Tullie House that the public don't usually get to see. We hold free drop-in activities to allow our visitors to participate on their own terms. The sessions are wide-ranging, but have creativity and learning together as their focus.
So the youth panel is a museum group for young people aged 14 to 21. It's a group that meets monthly, once a month all throughout the year, and then more often if we've got a project on. They get involved in a variety of activities. It's really important for the museum to get a young people's perspective.
The youth exchange is all about learning about each other's cultures. When we go to the different countries, it's important that we look at the different heritages. So we thought it was important to bring them to Tullie House.
We are exploring the museum and we're doing different activities in each section. And we're currently in the old Tullie House building and we are recreating different pictures around here.
We had to bring them here. We couldn't not bring them here really.
I'm Eric the Itchy, and welcome to the Deadly Dragons Festival here at Tullie House.
The Deadly Dragons Family Festival that we've got today is really about immersing the whole site into a Deadly Dragons experience, which is based on the How to Train Your Dragon books by Cressida Cowell. So the museum has been renamed. We've got, instead of the community room, we've got the Meathead Public Library. Instead of the garden, we've got Hooligan Village, which are all place names in Cressida's book. So the families we've had today have had such fantastic feedback about the live reptiles we've got. We've done dragon racing with some bearded lizards. They love the obstacle course, and they love our storyteller, Michael, who his alternative name is Eric the Itchy, and he's been teaching them how to speak Dragonese all day. So we've had fantastic feedback, and it's been a brilliant weekend. So we've had some challenging times. Some staff were reluctant to embrace families as a key visitor group. They thought it might alienate other visitors and dumb down our displays. This perception has been shifted over the past few years, thanks to the unflagging enthusiasm of my team and also the success of our programmes in attracting funding and visitors. We also work hard to maintain a balance in our displays and programming. Tullie House is not an interactive children's museum or a space dominated by children's activities. Our strength is that we cater to all of our audiences and are subtle in our approach. Families are embraced throughout the museum, but not in a way that excludes other visitors. Families spend money on our mission in the shop and in the cafe. On the days we run drop-in activities during the holidays, for example, visitor admission increases by between 80 and 100% every time. It makes financial sense to target families, and their loyalty is unparalleled. If you embrace them, they will keep coming back. Being approachable and accessible in our displays leads to excellence in terms of visitor numbers and quality of experience, which in turn leads to more money in the tills and more funders answering our knock on their door. Appealing to families doesn't mean you have to dumb down content. It's easy for a curator to write a panel or label in academic or intellectual language. What's hard is translating that into something non-experts can understand. And by making content accessible for families, you're actually making it accessible for all visitors who aren't experts, which, let's face it, is the majority. In the guidelines for this presentation, I was asked to give one piece of advice for anyone wanting to aim for this award. I had to think hard about this because, as I said, if I'm honest, we never expected to win the Family Friendly Award as the competition was so stiff. We were up against national museums and museums who recently had major redevelopments or invested thousands of pounds in their sites. We won without being or having any of this. We won because our commitment to our family visitors shines through in everything we do, and this was recognised at all levels of the competition. So thinking about how I could frame this as a piece of advice, I would say, be honest. Families know when you are doing something for the sake of it or for purely financial reasons. To appeal to families, you have to be honest and authentic and make sure you're doing it for the right reasons. Earlier in my presentation, I said that we'd recently launched our own museum manifesto. The primary pillars of this manifesto are to create a museum fit for the 21st century, a museum that has something to say about Carlisle, Cumbria, and the world in which we live, a museum that unleashes creativity and invites co-creation, a museum which is collections-based, curatorially informed, and audience-focused, a museum with a human face, providing a third space anchoring community life. Winning the Kids in Museums Family Friendly Award was a huge step in this direction and has set us on a path that we feel will make the museum sustainable, resilient, and inspirational for generations to come. Thank you.